Good evening. This is directed at the citizens of Ohio, Texas, Vermont, and Rhode Island that will be voting in their primaries and caucuses tomorrow, especially those that are considering voting for Barack Obama. My advice to you is think for a minute. I know that Obama is an exciting speaker. As a speaker, he is phenomenal. He speaks well. The question is, what is he going to be able to do to put those words into action? This is actually something my aunt and one of her friends, both of which who are strong and have been strong supporters of Hillary Clinton since 2006. But they asked me a question. What does Obama have in terms of specifics? And if you look at what the next president is going to be inheriting, specifics are going to be a requirement. The president that comes in 2009 is first of all going to be inheriting an economy that's going to be laden with debt, both national and personal. We'll also have to deal with a growing number of both unemployed and underemployed individuals, people working, not only not working, but people working at places like Walmart, Best Buy, and other aspects of the McEconomy. They're also going to be inheriting an America that, thanks to their predecessors' policies, is going to be regarded as an international pariah. Now, I know a lot of you don't approve of how Hillary basically gave Bush carte blanche on several occasions to fight the war. And personally, if Hillary would just come out and say that she got caught in the same climate of fear that President Bush used to trap most of America and most of Congress, I have a lot of respect for her, a lot more respect for her. But the question you Obama supporters need to ask yourselves, what has he proposed in terms of specifics? What plans does he have for restoring economic fairness and justice? What plans does he have for getting America back into the world community? Think. He's going to be around for a while. He'll have time to learn the ropes of Congress. He'll have time to learn how to deal with the sheepdog media of AM radio and its cable news affiliate. He'll have time to deal with the lure of the big money corporate contributors. He's got time. Politically, Obama's an infant. He hasn't been on the block very long. He's going to be around for a while. He'll still be able to inspire people. But the country ahead may not be a time for inspiration. Well, actually, it is a time for inspiration, as we've been living the last 7 years in a climate of fear. But this isn't just a time for inspiration. It may also be a time for perspiration. This is Graylion Productions saying good night and good luck.